the family of record-breaking fundraiser and, well, frankly, national hero, Captain Sir Tom Moore, say they want to use a day named in his honour to salute the achievements of other older people. The first Captain Tom Day will be held in June. Very pleased to say. We're joined now on the programme by Tom's daughter, Hannah Ingram Moore. Hannah, very good morning to you.
Good morning.
So take us through it. I can't believe that there is a single person in the country who would have any objections to there being a Captain Tom Day, but tell us a little bit more about the thinking behind it.
Well, thank you. Of course, this goes back just a little while. When my father moved in with us all those years ago, shortly after my mother had died, he said to me quietly, Hannah, I had become invisible to the world. You know, he's lost my mother tragically and lost all of that connectivity of visiting her every day, and said, by moving in here with you, you've given me my visibility back. And it just made us think, you know, with the incredible legacy my father has left, what can we as a family and the trustees and the Captain Tom Foundation do to have the greatest positive impact on society? And we feel it's staring us in the face that we need to celebrate and empower our aging population and connect the generations, with fundraising starting to support small and larger charities immediately, culminating in the Captain Tom Day to celebrate those older people, to celebrate our aging population and the beauty and power of connecting the generations.
Why do we think that so many older people have felt so marginalised? And this predates, of course, any mention of COVID-19 in these shores.
Yeah, I think that, look, the very evolution of the way that we live, you know, we've moved into more nuclear families and we have moved further away from our family members for work over the last 30 or 40 years. And inevitably, that means separation. I think that it has left us in a place where we aren't revering our older people, that we've lost sight of the fact that they have incredible wisdom, wit and energy and knowledge. And somehow we've lost that connectivity, and it marginalises our older people. They lose connectivity. And look, I think what my father showed is by being involved and at the centre of this incredible multi-generational family lifestyle, he had purpose and he had positivity. And every single day we asked him for his opinion, and he loved it.
I imagine he did. Given the huge amount of money that your father raised, given the huge public affection that there was for those fundraising efforts, one suspects that the efforts leading towards Captain Tom Day might raise a fair bit of cash. So just give us an idea of the kind of the charities that you would wish to see it spent on, the events and the projects that you can see this day supporting, you know, this year and as we move forward.
Well, thank you. And of course, that £40 million raised, if you remember, in just 3.5 weeks, went straight to NHS Charities Together. So the Captain Tom Foundation very much started from humble beginnings. And our aim will be to look at those charities, small and large, who are really getting to the essence of supporting our ageing population, but in the way that we want them to be celebrated, empowered. We want to give them a voice. That's what we're looking for. And one of the most exciting things that we have done is collaborated with the amazing Dame Esther Ranson, who has for years championed older people. And together we've come up with this incredible idea of creating a Captain Tom Award for innovation within the sector. Imagine if we can just spark the interest of some of those engineering and tech companies to try and solve some of the problems of our aging population, but, you know, keep that connectivity of the generations. So there is all to play for. We're very excited and we're really, really hoping that everyone will get behind us, because we need you.
It sounds fantastic, and we wish you all the very best with those efforts. But as we kind of edge slightly closer towards Christmas, of course, Captain Tom inspired people up and down the country, young and old. But, you know, he was your father, he was a grandfather. And I'm just wondering how Christmas is going to look this year without him there.
Well, there's no question that it will be a time of deep reflection. My father lived with us for 13 years. And we feel his loss, honestly, we do, on an almost daily basis. It's the house often feels empty because he was just a huge part of it. So there is no question, I think, that we will have quiet reflection and sad moments. But who could not smile at the incredible legacy of hope he's left us, this country and the world. And we just sincerely hope that you will believe in what we're doing now with that incredible legacy and in taking on this next challenge.
A legacy of hope. What a remarkably beautiful way to put it. Hannah Ingram-Moore, thank you so much for joining us in the programme. Really appreciate it.
Thank you.